Let's turn now to more of the concrete, practical, pragmatic part. You teach executives about developing a business model canvas, and there's been a lot written and talked about that. Can you just kind of distill for us, I mean, what's at the heart of that, creating the business model canvas? How is it linked to product innovation?
Yeah. So historically, again, because of the trajectory of goods and services, right, innovation has focused a lot on the product itself, as opposed to on the entire customer experience that surrounds that product. And so as we move to designing entire experiences, the implication is that we have to design all the elements of the business that touch on that experience. So take Apple again as an example. Tesla is also potentially an interesting example today, where, yes, the product itself is sort of at the heart of the experience. Although we were doing research on teenagers and music, and we found a teenager who was wearing the white Apple earbuds and the N tucked in his pocket, and he didn't have anything, it wasn't plugged into anything. So he had basically no functionality. He had no, right? But he wanted to be a part of the Apple story. He wanted to be a part of a bigger story. And I sometimes joke and say, wouldn't you like to have a story that's one people want to belong to so badly that they'll forego the basic functionality of the product, right? So when you think about all the elements of a business model, I've got, you know, who are the people I'm serving and what value am I providing to them? Not what features am I providing, but what value, what benefits am I providing to them? And that's where, again, Steve held that very clearly in his mind, right? But the other boxes are, so through what channels will I reach them? Do I own my own stores so that I can completely own that experience? Or do I give that out to other people, other channels? What kinds of relationships do I want to have with my customers? Is it arm's length transactional relationships? Or do I have a place where I can interact with them? So that's sort of the outbound side. On the capturing value end, there's how am I going to price these products? How am I going to derive my revenue or my income from them, which also has to fit with the rest of that. So that's all the pieces you have to think about to design what I'm actually delivering to the customer. So on the back side, I've got to think about key activities. What do I need to do? So do I need to do manufacturing on my own? Where do I get that beautiful titanium case that's on the computer, or do I form a partnership with someone who will do that? And so that whole back end has to get designed understanding the value I'm trying to create for the customer. Okay? HP, for many years, Hewlett-Packard, they did their own plastic injection molding because they couldn't buy four-color plastic injection molded keycaps for the calculator. And if you don't injection mold the plastic, then over time it wears off. And they didn't want HP calculators to ever have the numbers, and the symbols on the calculator pad wear off. But over time, companies outside began to be able to do that, and so they were able to outsource it. But all those decisions are linked to what I actually want to deliver to my customers. So Apple sort of clearly said, I want to control that entire experience. So I want to own my own stores. I want to manufacture stuff. Increasingly, they've outsourced. But so that's why the business model matters. Yes. I think it also matters today because, we talk about sharing economy or collaborative consumption economy. There are a whole bunch of different ways of thinking about, and if I think about I'm trying to define the value that I want to deliver, then I have to create that value, I have to deliver that value, and then ultimately I have to capture that value in some way, right? Those are the three core elements of a business model. And there's a whole bunch of different ways of doing each of those centered around understanding the value I actually want to deliver. So that's what we do. there's another tool that's actually very interesting in as a companion to the business model canvas, and that's what we call Lucy Kimball, who wrote the Service Innovation Handbook, talks about innovation ecosystem maps. So think about Uber again, saying, who are all the players in the transportation ecosystem? And recognizing, it's kind of a duh in hindsight, but recognizing that you and I have cars sitting around not doing anything a lot of the day that might well be used. So now all of a sudden I can become a taxi or a rental car company without owning that resource. So the ecosystem map says, wait a second, there's a set of resources and capabilities sitting over here that I can leverage in order to build my own business, right? So that's how Uber ended up with a different business model than a taxi company, was in part because they looked at this ecosystem and said, where might I get that resource in a different way than I've gotten it today?